मॉर्निंग क्लास. टुडे इज़ माय टॉपिक ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन इज़ प्लूरल विजन. सो यू ऑल नो व्हाट डू मीन बाय प्लूरल विजन. एक्चुअली प्लूरल विजन इज़ कलेक्शन ऑफ फ्लूइड इन द प्लूरल कैविटी और इन द प्लूरल स्पेस. एंड एक्चुअली इट इज़ रेयरली अ प्राइमरी डिजीज प्रोसेस, बट इज़ सेकेंडरी टू अदर डिजीज. The pleural space normally contains about 10 to 20 milliliter of the serous fluid, means that the pleural cavity is having normally 10 to 20 ml of serous fluid, and it normally seeps continuously into the pleural space from the capillaries lining and the parietal pleura, and is reabsorbed with the visceral pleura capillaries and lymphatic system. Any condition that interferes with either secretion or drainage of the fluid leads to pleural effusion. Means when there will be any kind of interference with the visceral pleura and the parietal pleura or their capillaries in the lymphatic system, then there will be a secretion or there will be a drainage of the fluid, which will lead to the pleural effusion. Now, what is the definition? Pleural effusion is a collection of abnormal fluid or pus in the pleural space. The pleural cavity, which is present in your chest. What will happen in that? There will be an collection of abnormal amount of fluid. Means the fluid is present, that I told you before, that 10 to 20 ml of fluid is inside the pleural cavity, but when it is exceeded than that, then it is known as pleural effusion. Now its classification, that is two types of exudates will be there. One is transudative effusion and one is exudative effusion. So what do you mean by transudative effusion? In transudative effusion, actually it is known as hydrotheresis. Hydrotheresis means actually it is a non-inflammatory condition in which there will be an accumulation of low protein or low cell count fluid. Means in that the pleural space, what will happen? There will be an accumulation of the low protein. And in what will be the causes of transudative effusion? That will be, you know, increase in the hydrostatic pressure, which is found in the heart failure. Means when there will be a heart failure, there will be increase in the hydrostatic pressure, which will be the common cause for the pleural effusion. Then decrease oncotic pressure. Alright, and why this happens? Because of the hypoalbuminemia. Found in the cirrhosis of liver, if the patient is having cirrhosis of liver or renal disease, then patient will have the hypovolemia. Then comes, in this condition, fluid volume is facilitated out of the capillaries and into the pleural space. What will happen? There will be a movement of the fluid from the capillaries to the pleural space. Exudate effusion occur in the area of inflammation, and there will be an accumulation of the high protein fluid. The exudative effusion will result in increased capillary permeability because of the inflammatory reaction, and actually this kind of effusion occurs secondary to the condition in which the pulmonary malignancies or pulmonary infection and pulmonary embolism. Means as I told you before, what will happen in this, there will be a movement from the capillaries and into the pleural space, due to which the pleural or transudative effusion occurs. What will be the etiology? Might be disseminated cancer will be there, particularly lung or breast cancer or lymphoma will be there, because of pleural pneumonary infection, that is pneumonia, any kind of nephrotic syndrome, heart failure or cirrhosis of liver. Other condition, that is sarcoidosis or systemic lupus erythematosus or peritoneum dilysis. What will be pathophysiology? Like if there will be an increase in hydrostatic pressure and there will be a decrease in oncotic pressure, what will happen? The fluid will unable to remain the fluid in the intravascular space. There will be, the fluid will not be in the intravascular space, due to which the fluid will shift into the interstitial space, which will cause effusion. In exudate effusion, there will be an invasion of the microbes, and due to which there will be an inflammatory reaction and vasodilation occurs, due to which there will be a leak of plasma protein and decrease in the oncotic pressure. So, what will be the clinical manifestation? In clinical manifestation, actually, there it is. Excuse me. It actually have the underlying disease or severity of the effusion. That how much is the effusion is severe. Like in pneumonia causes fever, or due to which there will be chills or pleuritic test or pain will be there. Malignant infusion. Effusion may result in dyspnea and coughing. When a small to moderate pleural effusion is present, dyspnea may be absent or may be minimal. All right, there will be a pain in the chest, that is the pleuritic chest. There will be a dullness or flatness or to the percussion. When we'll do the percussion, there will be a dullness. There will be an absent of the breath sound or decreased breath sound will be there. All right. Next is diagnostic evaluation. How we are going to diagnose it? Chest X-ray or ultrasound detects presence of fluid. Thoracentesis, biochemical, bacteriological, cytological studies or blood test is to be done. Like this is the chest X-ray in which you will see that there is the cloudy part. Here there will be a pleural effusion. When you see the X-ray, it is in the left lung. What will happen? This all upper lobe is clear and this lower lobe is filled with the pleural or fluid. All right. Due to which, when you will assess the patient chest with the stethoscope, you won't be able to assess it right away. All right. Means there will be any complication and you won't be able to see what kind of this pleural effusion occurs. Or you will see that the patient saturation will be decreased. In the management, to discover the underlying cause, actually we have to prevent the fluid accumulation, the extra fluid accumulation, and to relieve discomfort, dyspnea, and respiratory compromise. Generally, what we have to go, we have to treat the underlying causes due to which the pleural effusion occurs, like heart infection or any kind of heart disease or any kind of infection. Thoracentesis is done to remove the fluid that to collect a specimen and relieve dyspnea. For malignant effusion, chest tube drainage, radiation chemotherapy or surgical pleurectomy is to be done, or pleuroperitoneal shunt is to be inserted in this. Complication, there will be large effusion, could lead to the respiratory failure. If there will be increase in the increase in the you know increase in the this one fluid, then there will be a respiratory failure. Nursing assessment, in that we have to obtain the history of previous pulmonary condition, assess the patient for dyspnea and any kind of tachypnea, auscultate and percuss the lungs for abnormalities. In nursing diagnosis, ineffective breathing pattern related to collection of fluid in the pleural space, that is we have to maintain the normal breathing pattern. We have to evaluate the expected outcomes. Thank you. If you have any kind of doubt, kindly ask me. But first of all, we'll summarize the topic from where we had started. All right. So, first of all, we had studied about the introduction, then definition, classification. Two types of classification I had told you. Their pathophysiology and causative organisms I had told. Then comes the clinical manifestations and diagnostic evaluations. Then we had seen the one chest X-ray where the pleural effusion patient is there, and his X-ray will be like this only after this. And there we had discussed the management for the malignant and the normal pleural effusion. Then we had discussed the complication. We had done the nursing assessment and nursing diagnosis. Then we had seen the nursing interventions and evaluation and outcome. Thank you. So here we had discussed one thing, that is thoracentesis. So I would like to give you an assignment on thoracentesis. So kindly email me or WhatsApp me your assignments on thoracentesis. Thank you and have a nice day.